Hey guys, I just wanted to quickly remind you that I'm partnered with the folks over at Astro Gaming. If you need a new A40 headset, A50 headset, or if you're looking for a C40 controller, please feel free to visit the link down below in the description to get 5% off your entire order. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're going to be talking about three new teasers that just hit the internet over the past few days. These teasers are in regard to Season 5 and an event that's going to be happening on August 5th. A lot of people are speculating that this is going to be the nuke event. We'll talk all about that. Let's start off in the order in which these appeared. On Monday, there was a teaser sent out by NICKMERCS over on his stream. Then on Tuesday, we saw TylerTeePee actually put something out on his stream. And then just today, we got another teaser from JackFrags. So we're going to take a look at all three of these teasers, discuss them in the order in which they were released, and see if we can piece together any type of story that's happening here. All of the streams and links will be in the description below to these channels. So big thank you to TylerTeePee, NICKMERCS, and of course, JackFrags for allowing me to use their content. The first teaser actually shows the inside of a train and then a helicopter whizzing by. Then you hear the train horn go off. This train currently exists on the map. You can actually find it at the train station. This is the one right here. It's not accessible. You can't honk the horn. You can't break the windows and jump through. You just can't do anything with it as of right now. There have been rumors over the past month or so that there's going to be a train added to this map, and that's been shown by new train tracks and tunnels popping up all over the place. And I guess what's going to happen is when you're able to access this train, you can drive it personally, or is it just going to be moving around the map on its own? Tons of loot, maybe something to do with a limited time mode. We'll have to wait and see. As for the helicopter, it almost looks like it's leaving an area. And why could that be? Let's move on over to the clip that came from TylerTeePee, and this is actually showing an entirely new area. This is inside the stadium. It's also been rumored that the stadium's going to open, and we've seen in official images from Activision that the stadium has been opened, at least during these builds that they've been taking these screenshots. The stadium itself looks kind of dead at this point. There's nothing happening on the inside, and then all of a sudden there's this gigantic blast, and then the camera system goes out. At first I thought, oh, that's that nuke, because we know there's a nuke of some sort that's going to explode at some point. And then I started to think, well, maybe this is kind of like the EMP blast that we saw in Modern Warfare 2. The third option that I was thinking of, what if this is kind of more like a MOAB, where it isn't intended to destroy everything in its vicinity? It's more meant to be like a soft blast in a certain area. With all the intel missions that we've been doing around Verdansk and all of the stuff that we've been collecting over the past few weeks, it points to an event leading to the stadium, like where there's actually some sort of contraband being held there. If there is a nuke, and if it is being exploded from either in the stadium or around the stadium, that would be pretty interesting. But from the video that we're seeing, it looks like it's taking place quite a distance away, and then the blast itself hits the stadium, knocking out the signal of the video. I don't know if this is a MOAB or if this is a nuke, because you could be watching the signal from some sort of centrally located area way far away from Verdansk, and you could still see that no signal detected type of thing if a camera system goes out. So it really could go any way at this point. Also adding to this, because at this point it doesn't really make much sense with how they're building up to release this train situation. If there's a nuke going off, or something equivalent to it that's going to destroy a lot of places, how in the world is the train track still going to be held up? How in the world is any of that still going to work? You would think that trees would be crashed down over the tracks. You would think buildings would completely shred the areas around it. You would think that bridges would collapse and tunnels would collapse. It doesn't really make much sense for a train to even be able to be used, let alone operational, after a blast like this would go off. But that's kind of where I'm at in my mind. So let's take a look at the clip that JackFrags got. This looks like it's a tunnel that leads to the center of the stadium. Something that you would see the players come out of to start their matches. That's what I'm kind of guessing here. If this isn't that, then perhaps it's one of these two underground garages that will maybe be opening. As for the fire, I'm not entirely sure. There could have been something that happened in the center, a big explosion, if you will, and now the helicopter that we saw earlier in the clip from NICKMERCS, you can hear that actually coming in for a landing right here in this clip. So pairing all three together, it's kind of telling a story. There was an explosion, the helicopter heard that, and now it's heading over there from where the train yard was. At least that's what I'm getting from this entire situation. It still doesn't really make sense. Is the stadium itself exploding and that's why we're getting access to it? Are we getting an explosion on the outside? It's still pretty confusing. The other thing that all three of these clips share is the message itself came from Shadow Company. If that name sounds familiar to you, it definitely should. This is the same exact group of private military contractors that were under direct command of General Shepard from Modern Warfare 2. These guys meant business. They were loaded to the teeth with gear. They were trained similarly to military personnel because that's what they are. And they were doing things dirty, especially in Modern Warfare 2, but they knew what they were doing. So overall, I'm not entirely sure what they are going to be doing with Shadow Company in regard to Season 5. I'm not entirely sure if Shadow Company was sent in to intervene because of everything that we've been learning about the armistice and how it's kind of been falling apart and everyone's attacking their own friendlies. It's kind of just all over the place at this point. It honestly would not surprise me if Shadow Company made its way into Modern Warfare as an entirely new faction. In fact, that would be pretty badass because I've always been a huge fan of the way that the character models look when it comes to this particular group. And I think that it could play a huge role in the story, considering we know now throughout the little operator missions that we've been given and the intel missions that we've been doing over the weeks that we kind of are firing on ourselves. This armistice really hasn't done much good. It's only kind of brought bad to the entirety of Verdansk. The question is, who is controlling Shadow Company and why would they send them into Verdansk to clean up a mess or maybe even create a new one? Who exactly knows? The story is actually going pretty damn deep, and I'm excited to see where it leads. Shadow Company back in the flesh, and we're seeing proof of that with these little teasers that we've been getting. Anyway, guys, let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comments section. I truly hope you enjoyed this video with the teasers today. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on it, subscribe for more videos coming very soon, and if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Also, P.S. Shadow Company, they're the people that burned OG Ghosts and Roach to death, so yeah, I would like to see how they're looked at in this particular version of Modern Warfare. Obviously, this is a reboot, so anything could happen. They might even be on our side this time around. Who the hell knows? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.